Hey everyone. Wave 2 of Power of the Primes is still gradually making its way across the United States. So I'm taking another look at it through the Legends Class Decepticon duo of Battle Slash and Road Trap. Of course, take a close look at the packaging. Nice artwork once again. I feel like Battle Slash looks uncannily like Astro Train, and maybe just because of that odd perception, I feel like Road Trap also looks like someone else, but maybe not. Either way, I can't place the character. And the nice positioning of the robots. I have a spoiler for the review, but both have their combined form of Battle Trap along the side. Lots of product info, stuff about Prime Master integration, and very simple bio for each of them, printed in four languages. Torments Autobots with his Duocon partner. And insert the other one's name here. So let's get them out of there. Starting with Battle Slash, I suppose. Like so. At least a little. That could help a bit. While looking at the shelves of the Target they were at, actually looked through the side of the packaging to make to ideally get cards of them that had that used Prime Masters that I already have. So with that, Battle Slash has Micronus. Power links with allies to share his strength. Very simple, but is appropriate for both their abilities. appears to be able to. Strength, no, another arm. Take a close look at him, kind of a squat, bulky sort of physique. Good head sculpt. Nice color layout with the kind of grayish off-white, but broken up a lot through black, purple, the light blues. Nice spinning rotor blade on his arm. See, swivel head. Bit of odd shoulders that they can only move forward on the ball joint. That can tilt out, ball joint out of the elbow. And at the hip and the knee. It's a good overview of the robot mode. And to look at the instructions, unlike the Prime, I did with the Prime Masters. Actually, before that, I can briefly show my Cronus in his weapon form with the cloudburst armor. It shows simply that. Sorry about that. You can hold him in weapon mode pretty decently. Might have to balance on the end of the barrel. Is that? Okay. So straighten them out. Okay, this is gonna be tricky. Small pictures, quite a few steps. Looks like you angle his arms away like this. Yep. Maybe. Oh no. Tilt this forward. Goodness. Flip his head in. Then angle the arms out. Flip them up. Okay. Okay, there's a little joint along here. But you then flip them around. Them. So then once again, the inside of the elbow faces you. Then onto the legs, which hopefully are easier. Flip these end pieces past the feet. Them right at the knee. Looks like you also separate them at the lower body. Then actually flip them all the way around. And press them together. To make the back half of the helicopter mode. This piece down and around. Carefully, there's an extra joint there. Use to flip down the arm. Okay, yeah, there we go. Rotate them around. Two meet together in the middle. Ever so gradually. Tend them together from the back. And connect it all together. As close as you can, at least. Think you got it. And there we go. Boxy helicopter, but it's the job done. And the ridiculous Tank Master integration in vehicle mode is like so. Holding legs back, sitting them down, and just enough clearance to avoid the rotor blade. Actually, considering the runtime is already going, I think I'm gonna split this up, so. We'll at least see in the next one. Onward to Road Trap very soon.